In 1902, Alibhai Mula Jevanji started off one venture that would last 100 years, the Standard newspaper. He was not alone. Around the same time, the Kenya-Uganda Railway had laid tracks across East Africa, setting off another offshoot venture, the Sarova Stanley Hotel. Mark Namaswa with a brief history of these three establishments.
Standard Group, 100 years of bringing your world to you.
In 1902, an Indian immigrant, Alibhai Mula Jevanji, felt that the best way to articulate on issues happening around Kenya was through a weekly newspaper, the African Standard. But 6 years earlier, the Kenya-Uganda Railways, now Kenya Railways, had also laid the foundation of what it is today.
We are like engine-mates. And I believe the Standard Group newspaper, which began published in 1902, was as a result of the railway sector. As you know very well, most of the towns, most of the industries, most of the activities that came up in this country originated from the investment that was done through the Kenya Railway in those years.
And while the railway thrived in the colonial era, so did entrepreneurship. Mayence Bent, a lady of British origin, decided to set up what is now the Sarova Stanley Hotel in Nairobi's CBD.
This hotel that we are sitting in, Sarova Stanley, was launched in 1902, the same year as Standard Group. At that time, I believe it was called African Standard Newspaper, was also launched in 1902. So the connection is that we are both 116 years old. So I think that's very, very important from a historical perspective.
Bent started small, but what she put up stands to date.
Started with 6 rooms and grew to 60 rooms in 1915, but then before that, in 1905, there was a fire that burnt down the previous Stanley Hotel. And then she found land at the intersection of Kenyatta Avenue and Kimathi Street, which prior to this date was known as Delamere and 6th Avenue. So she got land here and built the hotel.
Today, the hotel strives to retell its history through this over 100-year-old swinging door, photos and historical artifacts and themes. But again, the legacy of the Standard newspapers pops up in this newspaper stand, arguably the oldest in Kenya and set up early in the colonial period. Through this time, the Standard newspaper evolved from the African Standard to the East African Standard in 1905, the Standard in 1977, then back to East African Standard, then in 2004 it became the Standard. In 1989, the Standard Group acquired the Kenya Television Network, the first privately owned TV station in Kenya, and now runs KTN News, Radio Maisha, Standard Digital, the Nairobian paper, among a diverse array of media products. In recent days, the Standard Group has partnered with fellow centenarian establishments in a collaboration that spans fields such as transport, media, tourism and hospitality, fresh from promoting battlefield tourism in Taita Taveta's Savo Circuit.
KTN was also there, the Standard Group was there to report once again very positively on that particular event. And from a tourism perspective, I think it's great that we are able to identify new product, battlefield related. And we want to partner with the Standard Group to make sure that we communicate that product in many, many angles. So, you know, the history, the connection and the opportunities exist between tourism and the Standard Group, and also between Sarova and the Standard Group. So we're very happy to be associated with the Standard Group.
More than 12 months when we started operating our Mandarake Express, we are carrying tourists towards Kilangun launch. They are lighting Butito and Day. Others are lighting Miazeni station and the 4 stations. And they move towards Kilimanjaro by road. But for us to improve that sector, we are looking at doing a SGR connecting Voi and Taita Taveta.
Mark Namaswa, KTN News.
Standard Group, 100 years of bringing your world to you.